ولكم في القصاص حياة يا أولي الألباب لعلكم تتقون.
الله سبحانه وتعالى made it clear that ولكم في القصاص حياة, يعني ولكم حياة في القصاص. There is a saving of life in the law of retribution. Because if somebody kill and that person is being killed, the next time if somebody wants to kill, he will say, if I kill him, I will die. So he will stop killing. Okay? So there, you can see that there is save of life. There is a saving of life in Qisas. But Allah said, Ya ulil albab, O men of understanding, men who are wise and prudent. That is not all, not those people who think we are intelligent. وَذَلِكَ أَنَّ الْقَاسِدِ لِلْقَتْلِ. Because anybody who wants to kill, إِذَا عَلِمَ أَنَّهُ إِذَا قَتَلَ, if he know that whenever he kills, قُتِلْ, he will also be killed, يُقْتَلْ, he will be killed, يَمْتَنِعُ عَنِ الْقَتْلِ, he will stop from killing. فَيَقُولُ فِيهِ بَقَاؤُهُ وَبَقَاؤُ مَنْ يَقْتُلُ. You can see that by not killing, he himself, he saved his life. He saved the life of the person that he's going to kill too. You understand the ayah? Because if he kill, we lose one. By killing, we lose one. He too is going to die. We lose two people. But if he stop killing, he saved his own self, his life. He also saved the life of the person that he's going to kill. Subhanallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that's why he said, Ya ulil albab, O men of understanding, la'allakum tattaqun. Perchance, you will be cautious. You have taqwa. Now.
كتب عليكم إذا حضر أحدكم الموت إن ترك خيرا الوصية للوالدين والأقربين بالمعروف حقا على المتقين.
Now, this ayah, it was working in the beginning of Islam. In the beginning of Islam, it was obligatory for the Muslims when they see a sign of death. When they see that they are going to die, they have to make a will. And the will that they have to do, in English they call it bequeath. I don't know the word. So, they have to do it to akrabin, to walidain. They have to write that this social amount has to be given to my parents, my mother and my father. Wal akrabin, and their relatives, those who are very closer to them. Okay? But not all, ala man mata lahu mal, but it is incumbent upon anybody who died, whereby he is rich, he have money. This law was what prevailing in the beginning of Islam. That is why you can see that here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Kutiba alaykum, ay furida alaykum. Idha hadara kutiba alaykum al-wasiyyatu. You see where the naibul fa'il is? It went far because the ayah is kutiba alaykum. إذا حضر أهدكم الموت إن ترك خيرا الوصية. The translation is كتب عليكم الوصية. Okay? Will had been made obligatory to you people. Okay? But إذا حضر أهدكم الموت, that is, if you see the sign of death with some of your relatives. إذا حضر أهدكم الموت, if the sign of death comes to one of you. And the condition is in taraka khayran. Khayran here means malan kathira. If the person has left a lot of money, then the wasiya, to make the wasiya is obligatory. Furida is obligatory upon him. And the wasiya, he made it to who? Whom is he going to give? Lil walidain. To the parent. You have to write something to be given to the parent. Wal akrabin. And also to the relatives, those who are very closer to him. According to Amr ibn Kharij, he said, "Kuntu akhizan bi zimam an-nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam." I was holding, this Sahaba said, I was holding the rope of the camel of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Faqal, and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "Inna Allah qad a'ata kulli dhi haqqin haqqah." Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given everybody his due right. Wa la wasiyya li waris. There is no will, there is no bequest on anybody who can inherit. The father can inherit his son. Okay? Anybody who can inherit, you cannot make wasi. You cannot write will that in your wealth they have to give him something. You are showing partiality. Okay? Which means this hadith has abrogated the ayah. That is, if you support the opinion that hadith can abrogate ayah, don't forget. Some ulama said hadith cannot abrogate ayah. Like Imam Shafi'i, he don't believe that hadith can abrogate ayah. His evidence is, Allah said in the Quran, ما ننسخ من آية أو ننسها ناتي بخير منها أو مثلها. That is, we abrogate a verse with another verse which is better than it, or another verse which is equal to it. And Imam Shafi'i said hadith is not equal like ayah, like Quran. Subhanallah, Allah has given some people understanding. You understand what Imam Shafi'i mean here? The verses of Quran, they are equal because they are all kalam Allah. Inna fadla kalam Allah ala kalam khalqihi ka fadli Allah ala khalqi. The way Allah, you cannot compare Allah with creature. The same thing, the speech of Allah and the speech of creature cannot be the same. Rasulullah is a creature of Allah. So his speech cannot be like the speech of Allah. Okay? This is the opinion of Imam Shafi'i. So it means hadith cannot abrogate ayah, because ayah is more superior than hadith. Because the ayah says, man and sah min ayatin, awnunsiha, na'ati bi khayrim minha. What, something which is better than it. And he said, hadith cannot be better than Quran. Awnunsiha, or something that the Quran can be better than, some of the ayah of Quran can become superior than some. And the verse of the Quran can be equal. But apart from that, there's nothing that can be supreme upon Quran. Because of that, Imam Shafi'i don't believe that hadith can abrogate ayah. And they asked him about this hadith and this ayah, that up to now he thinks that writing will for somebody who can inherit you is possible. And he said, no, it has been abrogated by ayah, not hadith. And they asked him, he said, يُوْتِكُمْ اللَّهُ فِي أَوْلَادِكُمْ لِلْذَكَرِ مِثْلِ الْحَظِّ الْعُنْسَيَيْنِ. Okay? If you read that ayah, that two verses of Surah An-Nisa, you can see all those people who can inherit. Imam Shafi'i said, because of this place of this ayah, those people, you cannot give them away. Allahu Akbar. But the majority of the ulama, they said, hadith can abrogate ayah. Because the hadith also, it is Allah who gave the hadith rank. Because Allah said, لَا يَنْتِكُ عَنِ الْهَوَىٰ إِنْ هُوَىٰ إِلَّا وَنْ يُوحَىٰ. The Prophet doesn't talk with his desire. All his movement, his speeches, all that he said is why. So the hadith can also abrogate ayah. Subhanallah. And some ulama said, no. This hukum, this ayah, kutiba alaykum iza hadara ahadakum al-mautu. Go. Iza taraka al-khayran al-wasiyya. Some ulama said, it is obligatory fi haqqi al-aqarib al-ladhina la yarithun. It's obligatory for every rich man. When he sees the son of death, and he has some relatives whom has no share in his inheritance, this ayah stand that he have to write something for them. I think people understand. Like your family, your relative, he don't have inheritance. He cannot inherit you. But you see that he is poor. Some ulama say this ayah still is there. You can write some of your wealth that take it to these people. Because the hadith, and Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, La wasiyata liwarith. There is no will for anybody who can inherit. But since this one cannot inherit, then the wasiyah can be applied on him. So it means the ayah still works. But it works on those that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala didn't mention them in the Surah An-Nisa. Ayah na wali Allah kibatu yusikum Allah fi Allah. I think ayah 13 on all here. The 10th ayah. Kuma ayah biwa Allah rabba gadu. Subhanallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shared inheritance in only two verses in the Quran. And those that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned there, they have been exempted from this thing. May Allah give us understanding. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Hakkan ala al-muttaqin. This making will, wasiyah, is a due right upon those who have taqwa, who fear Allah, those who are cautious. There is hadith. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made mention that anybody who has will to do, he don't have to sleep two nights except his will has been made. Okay? Ma hakum ra'in muslim lahu shar'un yusi bihi aw yusi fihi yabitu laylatayn illa wasiyatuhu maktuban 'inda ra'si. Okay? Any Muslim who knows that he has a will to do, he don't have to sleep two nights. He has to make sure that he writes his will, then it is under his pillow, because your life is not in your hand. It is in the hand of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he can do, he can take it whatever he wanted. Now.
فَمَنْ بَدَّلَهُ بَعْدَمَا سَمِعَهُ فَإِنَّمَا إِثْمُهُ عَلَى الَّذِينَ يُبَدِّلُونَهُ إِنَّ اللَّهَ سَمِيعٌ عَلِيمٌ.
فَمَنْ بَدَّلَهُ, and anybody who changed the wasiya, maybe you were there and the person may, oh, come, look, if I die, give this one this, give one this, and you come and change it. Maybe you change some of the money, you put your name there, you say, me too, you have to give me like this. Because maybe when he did this, nobody was there. فَمَنْ بَدَّلَهُ, anybody who changed the will, بَعْدَمَا سَمِعَ, after he had heard it, فَإِنَّمَا إِثْمُهُ عَلَى الَّذِينَ يُبَدِّلُونَ, then the sin will be upon the person who changed, not the person who made the will. The person who made the will, he made justice. Okay? Because don't forget, there are rules and regulations in making will. Somebody who is about to die, he cannot make will more than one tenth of his wealth. Okay? Because there is hadith. There is hadith. The hadith is according to Sa'd bin Malik. قال جاءني النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يعودني. The Prophet came to me to visit me when I was not well. According to the Sahaba, he was not well, and the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم visited him. فقلت يا رسول الله, and I said, oh Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم, أوصني بمالي كله. أوصي بمالي كله. I'm going to write, make will. I'm going to give all my money in will as a wasiya. La, the Prophet said, no, you don't have to give all your money. Like that. Go to Fashakum. And this Sahaba said, okay, I'm going to give half of my money. Kala la. The Prophet said, no. Go to Afulus. He said, okay, I'm going to give one tenth. Kala, the Prophet said, Afulus, one tenth. The Prophet said, Afulus Kathir. If one tenth is too much, the Prophet said, Innaka intada'a warathatak. Who? Akhniya. خَيْرٌ مِّنْ أَنْ تَدَعَهُمْ عَالَ يَتَكَفُّفُونَ النَّاسِ يَتَكَفُّفُونَ النَّاسِ بِأَيْدِيهِمْ. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, you, if you leave your heirs, those that will inherit you, agniya, that is sufficient, okay? You left them with sufficiently, they have with something, it's better, خَيْرٌ, it's better أَنْ تَدَعَهُمْ, that you will leave them عَالَ, poor. Yet then they will be begging people. Be IDing with their hands. So it's not allowed if you want to die then, because you give your wealth to sadaqah, then you leave your hands poor. You can see that Islam put everything at its correct place. And according to Ibn Abi Mulaika, because of this hadith, the Prophet said, Wasunus, some good, and majority of the other man say, you cannot make Meshkoshiya with more than one tenth of your wealth because of this hadith. And some say it, some don't support, some even see, because they say the Prophet said, Wa thuluth kathir, that one tenth is even more. So because of that, they see that even one tenth is more. To give one tenth of your money out and leave your head, they see it more, some of the ulama. Because there is, according to Abi Mulaika, Anna Rajulan, that a man, Kala li Aisha, a man told Aisha, radiallahu anha, Inni uridu al usi, I want to make will, I want to give up my wealth. Kala kam malik. And Aisha asked him, how many do you have? قال ثلاثة آلاف. I have 3,000. قالت, and Aisha said, كم عيالك? How many عيال? How many people are you feeding? Responsible like your family, your wife and your children. قال أربعة. He said, I have 4 people. قالت, إنما قال الله. Aisha said, Allah said, إن ترك خيرا. If the person has left a lot of money, وإن هذا شيء يسير, you only this 3,000. It's a small money. It's a chicken change. So fatrukli ayalik, it's better you leave this money for your family. You see, just this Islam consider the health. You don't have to leave your children and your destiny with poverty. Whereby you are going to, you take all the money and go and build big masjid. Then you leave them poverty. Islam don't accept that. The hakim will not accept it. They will take the money back to the family. If, should in case, it is Islamic State. Waqala Ali, radiallahu anhu, according to Ali, he said, La an usiya bil khumus. To give my one fifth of my money, okay? I have ila yamin an usiya bil rubu. It is better for me. I prefer it than giving one quarter. That is than giving quarter.
ولا أن أوصي بالربا also to give quarter I have إلي من أن أوصي بالثلث it's preferable to me than giving one tenth okay فمن أوصى بالثلث فلم يترك Ali said anybody who make wasi who give one tenth of his wealth outside فلم يترك شيء he didn't leave anything for his family it means okay so it means here he's supporting the opinion that you don't have to even make to make wasiyah with sulus even you don't accept it. You think it is it seems like you are living your family with poverty. Subhanallah. Fala waqal Hasan al-Basri. Hasan al-Basri said radiallahu anhu. He said you see the sulus our khums our ruba. He said it's better if you want to make wasiyah you make it 1/5 or quarter or 1/6. Sulus 1/6 or 1/5 or quarter. So it means Hasan al-Basri also don't support the thuluth. You know why? Because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said for thuluth kaseer. That is why they don't support this to give even sulus. The evidence is the Prophet said sulus. But according to the fuqaha, you can do sulus because they said the Prophet didn't criticize it. Okay? But the best good means I support is better you leave your family with something. If you think your money is too many and you give even 1/10, even what you have left for your family is even enough for them, for that one, no problem. Okay, in order to bring all together. But if it can help them, then it's not advisable to do that. To give up your wealth and then leave your children with poverty. Wal-iyazu billah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then he said, فَمَنْ بَدَّلَهُ Anybody, غَيَّرَ الْوَصِيَّةِ Anybody that will change the wasiyah, yani al awsiya, those who are making the wasi, awul awliya, or those who are responsible, the awliya, aw shuhud, or those who are witness. Ba'da ma sami'a, ba'da ma sami'a al qawl al musi, after they have heard the speech of the testator, of the bequeather, of the person who made the wasi, they hear and then they change it after his death. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَإِنَّمَا إِثْمُهُ عَلَى الَّذِينَ يُبَدِّلُونَ The sin of changing the wasiyah, the will, is upon those who change it, not upon the person who made it. Because the person who made the will, he made it correctly. He didn't make it more than 1/10. But you people, you change, you made it more than 1/10 so that you can get something wrong. You put your names inside. That's what is happening in Africa today. You know, I'm looking for Shuyukh to give me a fatwa of the money that the ulama they take from when they share inheritance. They charge, they even charge. I need fatwa in this. I need evidence. If they take themselves in ways that hadar al-kismata ulil qurba wal yatama farzuquhum minha no problem. We can say we give you something, but they charge. If you didn't pay like this, we don't give you. Maybe we don't share for you. And maybe these people, they are orphans. Some rich man died in Ghana and some ulama, they say they will take 2 billion before they share. Because they say he's rich, he left too much money. Your eyes in his money? Subhanallah. May Allah give us understanding. The thing you share, Allah will pay you. It's the work of Allah. If they give you, take it. But we allow us to them. May Allah forgive us. May Allah forgive us. فَإِنَّمَا إِسْمُوا عَلَى الَّذِينَ يُبَدِّلُونَ إِنَّ اللَّهَ سَمِيعٌ لِمَا أَوْسَى Allah hear you when you are making your wasi. Allah hears you. The wasi that you are making. عَلِيمٌ Also knows the تَبْدِيلِ الْمُبَدِّلِ You do that, you are a witness. If the person that money he died before people come, you make fast, you put the amount higher so that and you put your name so that you to your share will come inside, Allah know. Ali. And he will hold each and everybody responsible for what he did. Now.
فَمَنْ خَافَ مِنْ مُوسٍ جَنَفًا أَوْ إِثْمًا فَأَصْلَحَ بَيْنَهُمْ فَلَا إِثْمَ عَلَيْهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ غَفُورٌ رَّحِيمٌ
فَمَنْ خَافَ أَيْ عَلِمَ You see the language of Quran, خَوْف is to fear. But here is not fear. Here خَافَ means عَلِمَ فَمَنْ خَافَ فَمَنْ عَلِمَ Anybody who know مِنْ مُوسِن or see or know from the person who is making the will, the testator, Jonathan, that is going to deviate or Isman or is going to be unjust. He's going to cheat his children. He wants to give all his money and left his children poverty. Okay? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala aslaha alayhi. Then he makes suluh. He gives him advice. Fala ifma alayhi. Then there's no sin upon him. Okay? Or maybe he gave the person half married, but the person didn't hear. He made them a secret. He said, well, half of my money should be given to this. Then he leave his children with, not that he stay in debt. Okay? When he did that, then he died. Then you, the person testator, you change it. You make it one-fourth or one-third. Father Ismail Ali. Because you are applying what? Sharia. You are defending Sharia. You are doing justice. Because you have understand, you have known that the testator is doing injustice. He's trying to leave his family with poverty. So here, you can see that فَمَنْ خَافَ أَيْ عَلِمَ. It is not only this place that the word khafa means alima. There is also in places in Quran, like when Allah said, فَإِنْ خِفْتُمْ أَلَّا يُقِيمَ هُدُودَ اللَّهِ. If you know that they are not going to implement the rules and regulations of Allah, فَإِنْ خِفْتُمْ أَيْ فَإِنْ عَلِمْتُمْ. That is why we always say that Quran has its own language. Quran has its own language. May Allah give us understanding. فَمَنْ خَافَ. And Allah said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, مِنْ مُوسِلْ. If you know from the testator, the person who is making the wasiyah, قَرَأَ حَمْزَ وَالْكِسَائِي وَأَبُو بَكَرْ وَيَعْقُوبْ بِفَتْحَ بِفَتْحَ الْوَعْ وَتَشْدِيدِ الصَّادِ. In some qira'a, some of the ulama of qira'a of tajweed, this place, they read it, فَمَنْ خَافَ مِنْ مُوَسِلْ. Not مِنْ مُوسِلْ. In our Quran, it's مِنْ مُوسِلْ. But in some Quran, it's مُوَسِلْ. By making the wa fatha and then putting shadda on the sword. مُوَسِلْ. In some Quran. Okay? There are so many places where the sword of wasiyah has shadda in Quran. كَقَوْلِهِ تَعَالَى. There's a place where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَصَّادِهِ نُوحَ. He didn't say وَصَّى. وَصَّى. Okay? And he said, وَوَصَّيْنَ الْإِنسَانِ. So it means if those who did مِنْ مُوَسِّلْ, it coincides with this place, that the sword has got shadda. It has the same meaning. It doesn't change the meaning. This is Arabic. Okay? And in some qira'ah, وَقَرَى الْآخَرُونَ. And some of the ulama, they read it بِسُكُونِ الْوَى. The school means the word don't have neither fataha or kasra or dhamma. Okay? It has no shakl. Okay? وَتَخْفِيفُ sword. And the sword will be without shadda. Because the opposite of strong is easy. Takhfif is easy, light. And stark is shadda. And light is takhfif. Okay? And then too, they have references from the Quran where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned this word wasi, and he didn't put shadda on the sword. Like where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, يُوصِيكُمْ اللَّهُ فِي أَوْلَادِكُمْ. When he said, مِنْ بَعْدِ وَصِيَّةٍ يُوصِي بِهَا أَوْدَيْنِكُمْ. Subhanallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَمَنْ خَافَ أَيْ مَنْ عَلِمَ جَنَفًا أَيْ جَوْرًا. Anybody who saw جَوْرًا, unjust, cheating, وَعَدُولًا, and deviation from the right and the haq. Well, janaf means mail, to deviate, to turn from the straight path. Okay? Our ithman, or anybody who know injustice, zulman, sin, from the person who is making the testator, that he want to cheat his children. He want to leave them. Maybe he's not in good time with them, so he want to give his money out, then he left them with poverty. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, according to Qalas As-Suddi wa Ikrama wa Rabia, وَمَنْ خَافَكُ فَمَنْ خَافَنِي. فَمَنْ خَافَ مِنْ مُوسٍ جَنَفًا. According to Ikrama and Suddi and Rabia, Janafa is khata. Okay? Mistake. وَإِثْم is deliberately amd. The person, he gave two-thirds, or he make wasi, but he don't know. It's mistake. Then you remind him, hey, Islamically, you don't have to do more than one-third, less than one-third. Okay? Islamically. Or you see that the person know that you don't have to give less than one-third, but intentionally you want to do. I'm done. You can also advise him, hey, don't do that. That is explanation given by this scholars. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَأَصْلَحَ فَلَا إِسْمَ عَلَيْهِ. And what? No? فَأَصْلَحَ بَيْنَهُمْ. And you make justice or peace between them. فَلَا إِسْمَ عَلَيْهِ. You say, oh, don't do that. These are your children. You have to give some more. Then you left something. You try to make peace among them. Okay? وَاخْتَلَفُوا فِي مَعْنَى الْآيَةِ. According to Mujahid, معناها عندنا الرجل إذا حضر مريضا وهو يوصي that a person you came that you met a sickler is writing his will. فرعاه يميل. Then you see that he's deviating. He's doing something that is not correct. It might be taksir. Either he's reducing our israf or he's extravagant. He's making extravagant in the extravagant. Good. Extravagance. In the will. أو وضع الوصية في غير موضعها أو he put the وصية in a place that is not correct like the person inheriting some of your children there are tricks like your children they inherit you since the your children are there your children they don't have to inherit you the inheritance is for your children then you love one of your children and that one has children all of them have children but because you love that one you want him to get money then you say I make will for this my Jika, English. My grandchild. They will tell you, hey, Papa, it's not justice. This all your children, you have all this grandchild. What can't you do? Then you advise him. Because you know that it's a trick he is doing. He wants to leave money for this because he loves this child of him. You can give your child gift if you are healthy, you are anything, not the time of death. Even the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam prohibits from giving your child gifts without giving the others. Because it brings injustice among the family. Okay? They are all your children. You have to try to do justice among them. Or you can give some gift to encourage them. Maybe they are going to school. This one always is in the house learning this one. Pray. Then you show you do good for him, for them. You say, yes, because if you put to do the way like this one is doing, I'll do the same thing for you. That is different. That is a kind of way of educating the children. Like we can see. Muhammad Al-Amin Ash-Shinkaitri, when he was kid, if he is going to learn Quran, he's going to study the way his mother used to dress him extra. Wear him very nice clothes. She put him on a camel because he was an orphan, but his father left him with wealth. Then one camel will take his water and his food. Then she will take one slave to accompany him. Because of how do you think? The boy will always like to go to madrasa. Even if he's to travel far away to technology, he will go. Because, you know, during that time, his mother do whatever he want for him. He's aware of encouraging the children to learn. So, if you see that a person is going to do some injustice, okay? فَلَا حَرَجْ عَلَى مَنْ حَضَرَهُ أَنْ يَعْمُرَهُ بِالْعَدَلِ There is no sin for you, blame. You, the person who are there at present, to tell him to do justice. Hey, you don't have to give this your grandchild and leave this once. If you want to give them, give all of them. He said, no, you know, because this one, I like him. He said, no. It's a trick. Maybe you like the father more than all of them, so you want the money to go to the father. We call it indirect gift. They make the gift to the child, but it's not for the child. There is a name given in Sharia. They call it Janaf something something. There's a term given in Sharia concerning such type of gift. Now, when Hawani Janaf, then Wakala Akhanu Sabulama said, no. إِنَّهُ أَخْطَعَ الْمَيِّتِ فِي وَصِيَّتِهِ That dead person made mistake in his wasiya, أو جارة, or he cheat متعمداً deliberately. فَلَا حَرَجْ لِوَلِيهِ أَوْ وَصِيهِ أَوْ أُولِي الْأَمْرِ الْمُسْلِمِينَ أَنْ يُسْلَى بَعْدَ مَوْتِهِ After he died, there's no blame for the person who was the witness, the person you call him, look, this is what I'm doing for him to change it, to do justice. Or the wali, or the hakim, Muslimin, to do justice. That one, even after his death, there's no problem, since they know that he made injustice. He gave more than half of his wealth to some people, then he left his children without money. They have to do just, they don't have to comply with. If they try to advise, he refused, they leave him. If he died, they don't do what he said. They do according to what Sharia said. They will give the people that he said they should give, but they will not give them half. Okay? Maybe they can give them 1/4 or 1/5. Since it's not debt. If it is debt, that his pay is different. But they have to favor the children. This is Sharia. You can see that Islam put things at the right channel. لا ضرر ولا ضرار. May Allah give us understanding. Inna Allah Ghafur Rahim. Allah is oft forgiving and merciful Allah. I think we will sleep here, inshallah, since we sleep Ghafur Rahim. We make tawassul with the very beautiful Inna Allah Ghafur Rahim. May Allah look and then forgive us. Forgive us our sin. May Allah forgive our brothers who has passed away, our Amen. Parents, everybody that has passed away, may Allah forgive them. Amen. We do that, we are here. Those who are not well, may Allah cure them. Amen. Those who are with their healthy, may Allah prevent our health for us. Amen. our brothers in hospital who are sick, may Allah cure them. Our children that we are born in here, may Allah bless them. May Allah let them grow in the deen. Everybody who is working here, may Allah bless his work. And somebody, nobody, anybody who is not having work, may Allah give him work. Our families, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala let them develop the love of deen. Especially we the Africans, our sisters. Most of the time we used to see them in town, you know, walking like yo-yo, you know. We always like to advise them so that may Allah put the deen in their heart. We want our sisters to know that they are Muslims. If they are working, no problem. At least even if you couldn't recover your chastity. Allah has given you a very beautiful, I know my sisters will look this one, so I have to say maybe they're here, maybe through this one, Allah will help me, they will do it. If they are going out, their beauty, they have to cover it. The beauty is for only them and their husband. They don't have to be exposing it for everybody to see. It's a precious thing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had given them. So we pray, may Allah let them understand this thing. Yeah. So that they, because their children, they always do what they see their parents doing. When the children see their mother, like for example, a small girl is coming, she don't wear hijab, she's coming to madrasa. Then I look the mother, I see the way the mother dress, I don't blame the child. Even if I tell the child to put hijab, it will not work. It will not work. Because the mother is not putting. So how can she put? So may Allah give us understanding. Amen. May Allah bless our children. Amen. Bless our marriages. Amen. May Allah let us remain in the deen till our last time in the life. Amen.